So topic for today is tumors of liver. According to your syllabus, you should know about classification of tumors of liver and detail about two tumors, hepatoblastoma and hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, just two tumors. You should know about classification and about two tumors, hepatoblastoma and hepatocellular carcinoma. About classification of tumor. Okay, hepatic tumors can be classified as any other tumors. There are primary tumors as well as secondary tumors. Secondary tumors means tumors metastasizing to livers are secondary. Primary tumors can be again divided into benign tumors and malignant tumors. Benign tumors include hepatocellular adenoma, bile duct adenoma, and hemangioma. And malignant tumors include hepatocellular carcinoma, hepatoblastoma, cholangiocarcinoma, cyst adenoma, angiosarcoma, embryonal sarcoma, and metastatic tumor. The most common tumor that metastasize to liver are from colorectal carcinoma. Okay. Most common tumor metastasizing to liver is colorectal carcinoma. And other tumor that may metastasize to liver include tumor breast, esophageal carcinoma, stomach, pancreas, lung, kidney, and skin. So most common secondary tumor is tumor of colon and rectum that may metastasize to liver. Most common secondary tumor is tumor of colon and rectum. And other secondary tumors are tumors of breast, esophageal cancer, stomach, pancreas, lung, kidney, and skin. Okay, you should know about this classification and detail about this hepatocellular carcinoma and hepatoblastoma. Okay, remember, okay, most common secondary tumor in liver is tumors of colon and rectum. Okay, now let us start with hepatoblastoma. Hepatoblastoma, it is the most common liver tumor of early childhood. Okay, it rarely occurs over the age of 3 years. So it is exclusively, okay, there are two variants of hepatoblastoma, two anatomical variants, epithelial type and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal type. Okay, epithelial and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal type. Epithelial type means there is epithelial differentiation, and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal type means there are mixture of both epithelial and mesenchymal differentiation. Okay, differentiation means it is the process during which young and immature cells, okay, take the characteristic of mature cells. Okay, differentiation means it is the process in which young and immature or unspecialized cells that take an characteristic of mature and specialized cells. Okay, epithelial type means cells with epithelial differentiation. So epithelial cells with epithelial differentiation. Okay, so in this epithelial differentiation means if the cells acquire specialized feature of epithelial cells. Epithelial cells means any of the cells making the epithelium, like squamous cells, columnar cells, etc. Okay, epithelial differentiation. And mesenchymal differentiation means if the cells are differentiated into mesenchymal cells, okay, like specialized cells are mesenchymal cells. In this context, mesenchymal means cells forming bone cells, okay, like osteoblast, chondrocyte, cartilage cells, okay, myocyte, muscle cells, and adipocyte, fat cells. Mesenchymal differentiation means cells forming mesenchymal component, okay, differentiated into, in this mesenchymal differentiation, cells are differentiated into specialized type of cells forming mesenchymes, which include bone, muscle, cartilage, and fat. Okay, bone, muscle, cartilage, and fat. So if any tumor, there are bone, muscle, cartilage, or fat, that means there is, if the cells are differentiated into bone, muscle, cartilage, or fat, means there is mesenchymal differentiation. Okay, so in case of epithelial differentiation, cells are composed of polygonal fetal cells or early embryonal cells. Okay, recapitulating liver development means cells resemble to, okay, by definition, blastoma. Okay, blast means immature cells. Hepatoblastoma means it consists of immature cells. Okay, immature cells during the process of liver development. Okay, so epithelial type of hepatoblastoma, it resembles cells of during the process of liver development, means immature cells. Okay, that ultimately forms liver. So in case of epithelial type, it is composed of small cells. Okay, that resembles the cells in the process of early development of liver. Okay, during fetal period, during early development of liver, it resembles similar type of cells that were present in the early development of liver. Epithelial type means that, okay, in this context. And mixed epithelial and mesenchymal type means that epithelial type, okay, the cells resembling early development of liver is also present, plus there is cells with mesenchymal differentiation, means there are either osteoid, cartilage, or muscle cells. Okay, there may be, in addition to cells of epithelial type, there are cells with osteoid differentiation, cartilage differentiation, or muscle differentiation. Okay, so there may be bone cells, cartilage cells, or muscle cells, in addition to those cells resembling cells in the early development of liver. And okay, there is usually no pleomorphism. Pleomorphism means variation in size and shape. There is usually no variation in size and shape of the cells, and no tumor giant cells, and no mitotic figures, and no associated cirrhosis. Okay, pleomorphism, tumor giant cells, and mitotic figures, these all are present in hepatocellular carcinoma, but they are usually not present in hepatoblastoma. Okay, hepatoblastoma means blast means immature cells. So epithelial type, it is composed of immature cells. Okay, and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal types, it is composed of those immature cells resembling liver in early development plus cells with mesenchymal differentiation. Means in addition to those epithelial cells, there is also cells, there are also bone cells, cartilage cells, muscle cells, or adipocyte cells. Okay, so this is the hepatoblastoma with epithelial differentiation. And this is second picture is hepatoblastoma with mixed epithelial and mesenchymal differentiation. Okay, so in epithelial differentiation, these cells resemble cells in the early development, immature cells. Okay, these are all immature cells in the early development of liver. Okay, these cells are usually immature cells are rounded with open up chromatin. Okay, these cells are rounded cells, rounded immature cells. Okay, all these cells are with INC ratio. And in this mixed epithelial and mesenchymal differentiation, there are this epithelial, immature epithelial cells also. In addition, there are components of some mesenchymes. Here there is presence of osteoid. Okay, these all are osteoid. So there are epithelial cells as well as mesenchymal cells. Okay, osteoid bone cells. Okay, immature bone cells. So there is osteoid differentiation too. So this is pure epithelial hepatoblastoma, and this is mixed epithelial and mesenchymal hepatoblastoma. Okay, second picture is of mixed epithelial and mesenchymal hepatoblastoma because there are osteoid cells also. Okay, these all are osteoid cells. In pathogenesis of hepatoblastoma, there is frequent activation of WNT signaling pathway. Okay, there is activation of WNT signaling pathway, and it may be associated with familial adenomatous polyposis, Beckwith-Wildman syndrome, Lee-Fromenny syndrome, trisomy 18, and Wilms tumor. Okay, familial adenomatous polyposis means you may have read it in GI. Okay, familial adenomatous polyposis is a inherited condition. Okay, in its numerous adenomatous polyps. Okay, numerous polyps are present in the epithelium of large intestine. Okay, in familial adenomatous polyposis, it is a inherited condition in which numerous polyps are present in the epithelium of the colon. Okay, that is familial adenomatous polyposis. And this Beckwith-Wildman syndrome. Okay, you will also study about Beckwith-Wildman syndrome in renal. Okay, in context of Wilms tumor, it is also a risk factor of Wilms tumor. Okay, Beckwith-Wildman syndrome, it is an overgrowth syndrome. Okay, with macrosomia, macroglossia, organomegaly, okay, renal abnormalities, and neonatal hypoglycemia, Beckwith-Wildman syndrome. And most important feature of Beckwith-Wildman syndrome is ME hypertrophy. Okay, we will study about detail of Beckwith-Wildman syndrome when we study about Wilms tumor. Okay, Beckwith-Wildman syndrome, there is special feature is ME hyperplasia or ME hypertrophy, means there is asymmetrical overgrowth of one or more regions of the body. Okay, that is Beckwith-Wildman syndrome. Okay, it is overgrowth syndrome. Okay, it is known as Beckwith-Wildman syndrome is known as overgrowth syndrome associated with macrosomia, means the newborn baby is larger in size than average. Next is macroglossia, means there is abnormal overgrowth of tongue. Okay, organomegaly. Okay, there may be hepatomegaly, splenomegaly. There is omphalocele also. Okay, during birth, intestine may protrude out. That is omphalocele. And there may be neonatal hypoglycemia. And a special feature is ME hyperplasia or ME hypertrophy, means asymmetric overgrowth of one or more regions of the body. Okay, Beckwith-Wildman syndrome. And next is Lee-Fromenny syndrome. Okay, Lee-Fromenny syndrome, it is associated with mutation in P53 gene. Okay, and it is associated with increased risk of various cancer. Okay, which include osteosarcoma, breast cancer, leukemia, adrenocortical cancer, etc. Okay, Lee-Fromenny syndrome, it is a syndrome associated with mutation of P53 gene, okay, P53 tumor suppressor gene, and it is associated with increased risk of various tumor like osteosarcoma, soft tissue sarcoma, breast cancer, brain tumor, leukemia, and adrenocortical cancer. Okay, next associated is trisomy 18. Trisomy 18, it is known as Edwards syndrome. Okay, and the child is a child of Edwards syndrome are born with congenital heart disease like BSD, ASD, PDA. Okay, ventricular septal defect, arterial septal defect, and their child may have kidney malformation, omphalocele, intellectual disability, and small head or microcephaly, as well as cleft lip and palate, undescended testes, etc. Okay, Neuphromeny syndrome. Okay, it leave. Trisomy 18. Trisomy 18 is also known as Edwards syndrome. Okay, and child may be born with congenital heart disease, kidney malformation, intellectual disability, microcephaly, cleft lip and palate, and undescended testes. Okay. Okay, well, writing about hepatoblastoma, you can just write about the name, and we'll go in detail about each topic separately, okay? And this hepatoblastoma, they are not associated with cirrhosis, okay? Hepatocellular carcinoma, usually they are associated with cirrhosis, but hepatoblastoma, as it occurs in early years, okay? They are not associated with cirrhosis. Okay, so main thing is to remember about hepatoblastoma is they are exclusively tumor of early childhood, and they will not occur in adulthood. There are anatomical variants are of two types, okay, epithelial type of hepatoblastoma and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal type of hepatoblastoma. Okay, by the name hepatoblastoma, blast means immature cells. So there are immature cells resembling those cells in the development of liver, epithelial, and mixed epithelial and mesenchymal means there are epithelial cells as well as cells with mesenchymal differentiation. Means there may be osteoid, there may be cartilage, there may be muscle cells, etc. And they are associated with, in pathogenesis, there is frequent activation of WNT signaling pathway, and certain syndromes are associated with hepatoblastoma, okay? Familial adenomatous polyposis, Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome, Neuphromeny syndrome, Edwards syndrome, and Wilms tumor. And these tumors are not associated with cirrhosis. Okay, treatment is surgical resection with chemotherapy. Treatment for hepatoblastoma is surgical resection with chemotherapy. And with this therapy, the 5-year survival rate of the patient is approximately 80%. Okay, so in prognosis, with surgical resection and chemotherapy, 5-year survival rate of patient is approximately 80%. Okay, that was with hepatoblastoma. Next is hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, second tumor is hepatocellular carcinoma. You should know about just two tumors in detail, hepatoblastoma and hepatocellular carcinoma. Second one is hepatocellular carcinoma, and it is most common primary malignant tumor of the liver. Okay, hepatoblastoma is most common primary malignant tumor of liver in childhood, and overall hepatocellular carcinoma is most common primary malignant tumor of the liver. Okay, so most common primary malignant tumor of childhood or early childhood or infancy, it is hepatoblastoma, but overall most common primary malignant tumor of liver is hepatocellular carcinoma. Male to female ratio is 4:1, means it is more common in male. And peak incidence for hepatocellular carcinoma is 5th to 6th decade of life. So it is common in 50s and 60s. Okay, and it is associated with hepatitis B infection and hepatitis C infection. So high incidence of hepatocellular carcinoma are seen in those areas where hepatitis B and hepatitis C infection is prevalent. Okay, so in etiopathogenesis, it is associated with hepatitis B infection. Okay, actually more than 85% of the cases of the hepatocellular carcinoma, they occur in countries with high rates of chronic hepatitis B infection. Okay, more than 85% of the cases of hepatocellular carcinoma occur in countries with high rates of hepatitis B infection. Okay, and these high rates of hepatitis B infection, they are common in countries, they are common in Asian countries like Southeast China, Korea, and some African countries. Okay, and the peak incidence of hepatocellular carcinoma in these areas is between 20 to 40 years. Okay, so as hepatitis B virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma occurs in younger age, okay, 20 to 40 years, almost 50% of the cases of tumor appears in the absence of cirrhosis. Okay, more than 85% of the cases occur in countries with high rates of chronic hepatitis B infection. And the countries with high rate of chronic hepatitis B infection are Asian countries like Southeast China, Korea, and some African countries. And the peak incidence of hepatocellular carcinoma in those countries is 20 to 40 years. And this means early years, okay? Early years, 20 to 40 years means. So almost 50% of cases of hepatocellular carcinoma associated with hepatitis B virus infection in those places appears in absence of cirrhosis. Means in 50% of cases, there is no associated cirrhosis. Okay, next is hepatitis C infection. Okay, hepatitis B virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, they are common in Asian countries and some African countries. Okay, and hepatitis C virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, they are common in Western countries. Okay, and hepatitis B virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, the age of onset is usually 20 to 40 years, means early onset. But hepatocellular virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, which are common in Western countries, they will present over the age of 60 years, means older age. Okay, hepatocellular in number one, it is associated with younger age, 20 to 40 years. But hepatitis C virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, they are associated with older age group, okay, more than 60 years. In case of hepatitis B virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, 50% of the cases, they occur in absence of cirrhosis. But in case of hepatitis C virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, more than 90% of the cases, they occur after cirrhosis becomes established. Okay, so in hepatitis B associated hepatocellular carcinoma, 50% of the cases occurs in absence of cirrhosis. But in case of hepatitis C virus associated hepatocellular carcinoma, more than 90% of the cases emerges after cirrhosis is established. Okay, third one is cirrhosis of liver. Okay, actually, most of the hepatocellular carcinoma are identified in the background of cirrhosis. But cirrhosis itself is not a premalignant condition. Okay, remember this. Cirrhosis itself is not a premalignant condition. And cirrhosis is not required for hepatocarcinogenesis. Okay, actually, that cirrhosis and hepatocarcinogenesis, that takes place in parallel manner. Okay, but cirrhosis itself is not required. Cirrhosis itself is not required for hepatocarcinogenesis. But cirrhosis and hepatocarcinogenesis, they occur in parallel manner. Okay, next risk factor is alcohol use. And fifth one is mycotoxin. Okay, mycotoxin, usually mycotoxin associated with pathogenesis of hepatocellular carcinoma is known as aflatoxin. Okay, it is produced by Aspergillus species. Okay, this alcohol and aflatoxin. Okay, aflatoxin, which is mycotoxin produced by Aspergillus species. Okay, they have individual risk factor. They are individual risk factor for hepatocellular carcinoma as well as the synergizes. Okay, with hepatitis B virus and hepatitis C virus to increase risk of hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, the alcohol and mycotoxin, they also increases the risk of hepatocellular carcinoma by increasing the carcinogenetic risk of hepatitis B virus and hepatitis C virus. Okay, alcohol and mycotoxin increase the carcinogenic risk of hepatitis B virus as well as hepatitis C virus. Okay, other is chemical carcinogens like nitrosamines. Okay, with food additives and certain associated miscellaneous factor, metabolic syndrome. Metabolic syndrome is syndrome associated with obesity, diabetes, and non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Okay, other are hemochromatosis. Hemochromatosis is due to increase in iron deposition. Okay, and other associated syndromes are alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, other types of viral hepatitis, as well as tobacco and smoking cigarette also increases the risk of hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, in pathogenesis, there is activation of beta carotene and inactivation of the tumor suppressor gene p53. Okay, inactivation of tumor suppressor gene p53 and activation of beta carotene are required for pathogenesis of hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, so most important risk factor is hepatitis B virus and second one, hepatitis C virus. And other associated risk factors are cirrhosis of liver, alcohol, mycotoxin, chemical carcinogens, and other associated syndrome are metabolic syndrome, hemochromatosis, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, as well as tobacco smoking and viral hepatitis also increases the risk for hepatocellular carcinoma. In clinical picture, okay, there may be ill-defined upper tumor of early side, and it is most common in infancy. Okay, most common in infancy. Okay, it is most common liver tumor of early childhood, and it will not occur in adulthood. Actually, it rarely occurs over the age of 3 years. Hepatoblastoma. In picture A, this is a unifocal large tumor. Okay, single tumor, single unifocal large tumor. And in picture B, it is multifocal tumor. Okay, multifocal tumor, and this tumor area is paler than the surrounding normal liver. This is normal liver, and these areas are tumor area. And this tumor area is paler than the surrounding area, surrounding normal liver. This is multifocal tumor. And first one is unifocal tumor. Microscopically, range from well-differentiated to poorly differentiated form. Okay, so the tumor may range from well-differentiated to poorly differentiated form. Most common pattern of the tumor cells is trabecular pattern. Okay, I will come to figure. Trabecular pattern means tumor cells are arranged in pods with more than 3 nuclei. Okay, this picture one is trabecular pattern. Picture A is trabecular pattern. Okay, so these are pods with present of more than 3 cells. Okay, or more than 3 nuclei. This is known as trabecular pattern. Most common pattern is trabecular pattern. Okay, and individual tumor cells from well-differentiated forms are comprised of. Okay, in any tumor, well-differentiated means that cells that look most like that normal cells. Okay, in case of well-differentiated squamous cell carcinoma, the tumor cells will resemble cells of squamous epithelium. Similarly, in well-differentiated hepatocellular carcinoma, the tumor cells will resemble more likely to normal hepatocytes. Okay, well-differentiated means cells will resemble to normal hepatocytes. Okay, well, in case of well-differentiated hepatocellular carcinoma, the cells will resemble to normal hepatocyte. And in poorly differentiated, there is no any signs of normal hepatocyte. Okay, and in poorly differentiated form, there are prominent pleomorphism, hyperchromatic nuclei, and they do not appear at all as hepatocellular. Okay, well-differentiated means they will resemble to normal hepatocyte, and poorly differentiated means they will not resemble at all to normal hepatocyte. Okay, well-differentiated means they will resemble to normal hepatocyte, and poorly differentiated means they will not resemble at all to normal hepatocyte. And in poorly differentiated form, there is prominent pleomorphism, as well as prominent pleomorphism means there is more variation in size and shape of the tumor cells. Okay, there is more variation in size and shape of the tumor cells, as well as the cells are large with more INC ratio and hyperchromatic nuclei. Okay, which are features of malignancy. Okay, and next important point is the presence of sinusoidal vessels. Okay, as in normal liver, presence of sinusoidal vessels surrounding the tumor cells are important diagnostic feature. And other common features are portal vein thrombosis, vascular invasion, and mitosis. Okay, in case of hepatoblastoma, there were absence of prominent pleomorphism, absence of vascular invasion, and absence of mitosis. Okay, but in case of hepatocellular carcinoma, portal vein thrombosis, vascular invasion, and mitosis, these are common feature. Okay, and main point to remember is the tumor cells, most common pattern is trabecular pattern. Most common pattern for hepatocellular carcinoma is trabecular pattern. And the tumor cells, they may range from well-differentiated form to poorly differentiated form. Well-differentiated form means tumor cells will resemble normal hepatocyte. And poorly differentiated means tumor cells will not resemble at all to normal hepatocyte. Okay, so A is trabecular pattern. Okay, this pattern is known as trabecular pattern. Okay, the tumor cells are arranged in pods with more than 3 cells thick. Okay, more than 3 cells thick or more than 3 nuclei thick. These are known as trabecular pattern of tumor cells. Okay, this is most common pattern. Okay, trabecular pattern. These tumor cells are arranged in pods with more than, okay, this dot 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 is nucleus. Okay, more than 3 cells thick or more than 3 nuclei thick. This trabecular pattern of tumor cells is most common pattern of tumor in hepatocellular carcinoma. And second one is pseudoglandular pattern. Okay, these tumor cells are forming gland-like arrangement and that may contain bile also. Okay, the tumor cells are forming like gland. Okay, B is pseudoglandular pattern and C is solid pattern. And D is there is presence of giant cells, okay, tumor giant cells in case of hepatocellular carcinoma. So you should remember that most common pattern in case of hepatocellular carcinoma is trabecular pattern, and tumor cells, they may range from well-differentiated form to poorly differentiated form. Okay, this is picture showing hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, in right hand side is well-differentiated. Okay,
so there is one special variant of hepatocellular carcinoma that you should know. Okay, that is known as fibrolamellar carcinoma. Okay, there is a special variant of hepatocellular carcinoma known as fibrolamellar carcinoma, and that variant of hepatocellular carcinoma, it occurs in young age group, okay, young male and female adults of 20 to 40 years of age. And this type of hepatocellular carcinoma, okay, fibrolamellar carcinoma, it is usually not associated with chronic liver disease. Okay, previously hepatocellular carcinoma in general, it was associated with chronic liver disease like hepatitis B virus infection, hepatitis C virus infection, and it occurs parallelly with cirrhosis. But in case of fibrolamellar carcinoma are not usually associated with chronic liver disease. Okay, they are not associated with hepatitis B virus, not associated with hepatitis C virus, and not associated with cirrhosis. So the prognosis of this type of carcinoma, the prognosis of fibrolamellar carcinoma is better. Okay, prognosis is better than that conventional type of hepatocellular carcinoma. Previously, we were talking about conventional type of hepatocellular carcinoma. And now, this is a special variant of hepatocellular carcinoma fibrolamellar carcinoma. Okay, and the prognosis, this fibrolamellar carcinoma, it is not associated with chronic liver disease like that case of conventional hepatocellular carcinoma. Okay, conventional hepatocellular carcinoma, it is associated with chronic liver disease like hepatitis B virus, hepatitis C virus, and hepatitis C virus. But the fibrolamellar carcinoma, which is a distinctive variant of hepatocellular carcinoma, it is not associated with chronic liver disease. Okay, it is not associated with chronic hepatitis B, not associated with chronic hepatitis C, and not associated with cirrhosis. Okay, present, it is grossly, it is present as single large hard squamous tumor. Okay, squamous tumor means hard. Okay, hard tumor with preponderance of fibrous tissue. Okay, there are more fibrous tissue, so it is hard in consistency. Okay, and on micro grossly, it is single. Okay, single and hard with adequate amount of fibrous tissue. Grossly, it is single and hard with adequate amount of fibrous tissue. And microscopic examination, it is composed of well differentiated polygonal cells. Okay, well differentiated polygonal cells which are separated by parallel lamellae of dense collagen bundles. Okay, okay, you can see here this pink color. Okay, pink, and these tumor cells have, these are tumor cells. Okay, these are polygonal in shape. Okay, this one is nucleus, and this pink color, eosinophilic, is pink color or eosinophilic cyto with pink or eosinophilic cytoplasm. Okay, these tumors have abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm because of more amount of mitochondria. Okay, with prominent nucleoli. Okay, these tumor cells are arranged in nest and cords. Okay, these are cords with, and the individual tumor cells are polygonal in shape. Okay, polygonal in shape with abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm. Okay, this pink one, all pink one is cytoplasm. Okay, eosinophilic cytoplasm. Eosinophilic means pink in color. Okay, this pink in color, pink cytoplasm. Okay, pink cytoplasm with prominent nucleoli. Okay, inside the nucleus, you can also see the nucleoli. Okay, inside the nucleus, this one pink one is cytoplasm. This dense pink one is cytoplasm. Inner one is nucleus, and you can also see the nucleoli. Okay, nucleoli inside the nucleus. So these tumor cells are polygonal in shape with abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm and prominent nucleoli. Okay, nucleoli are also prominent. You can see inside the nucleus, nucleolus. Okay, nucleoli are also seen. Nucleoli are also prominent. So these tumor cells are polygonal in shape. With main thing is, you should mention, there are abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm. Okay, with prominent nucleoli. And between these tumor cells are five. These are all fibrous band. Okay. This dense pink area is area of the tumor cells, and this light pink area is of fibrous tissue. Okay, and between this tumor are presence of parallel bands of fibrous tissue. Okay, so it, fibrolamellar carcinoma, it is distinctive variant of hepatocellular carcinoma, occurs in young age group. Okay, 20 to 40 years of age. Usually, it is not associated with chronic liver disease like conventional hepatocellular carcinoma. And the prognosis of fibrolamellar carcinoma is also good in comparison to conventional hepatocellular carcinoma. And grossly, these tumor cells are single and hard in consistency. And microscopically, these tumor cells are arranged in nest and cords. And the individual tumor cells are polygonal in shape with abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm. Okay, this dense pink is eosinophilic cytoplasm with nucleoli. And these tumor cells are separated by this fibrous band. Okay, light pink one is fibrous band. Okay, thank you. Okay, is there any question? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.